I'll be presenting a hip case today. A 65-year-old male, a farmer by occupation, presented with chief complaints of pain in the right hip since 6 months and difficulty in weight bearing and walking since 6 months. The patient was apparently alright 6 months back when he slipped and fell in his house and injured his right hip. He had severe pain in the hip, acute and onset, aggravated by movement, and he was unable to stand and walk. He was treated conservatively at a local hospital with bed rest and skin traction for a 1.5 month. The pain reduced in severity but did not subside completely. At present, he finds it difficult to walk, bearing weight on his right leg, hence he remains confined to the house and is also unable to squat or sit cross-legged. He has no history of similar trauma in the past, fever, loss of weight or any surgical intervention. He is a known case of hypertension on regular medications since the last 8 years. He has a mixed diet with adequate appetite and sufficient sleep with no bowel and bladder complaints, and he is a tobacco chewer, chewing one packet per day since the last 30 years. His family and social history are not significant. On general examination, the patient is conscious, cooperative, well-oriented in time, place and person. He has an average build and is malnourished. He is afebrile with a pulse of 72 beats per minute, BP is 130/90. And respiratory rate is 16 per minute. There are no signs of pallor, icterus, cyanosis, clubbing, lymphadenopathy, and edema. His cardiovascular system, respiratory system, and per abdominal examination do not reveal any abnormality. On local examination, I have examined my patient in the standing, sitting, and lying down position from front, back, and sides. He has a Trendelenburg's gait with lurch to the right. His right lower limb lies in the attitude of flexion and external rotation with the patella facing outwards. The right ASIS, patella and median malleolus appear at a higher level than the left, indicating there is a shortening of the right lower limb. There is a wasting of the right gluteal and thigh muscles. There are no scars, sinuses, ulcers, dilated veins, discoloration. He also has an exaggerated lumbar lordosis. I forgot to mention, sorry. On palpation, my inspectory findings are confirmed. There is no local rise of temperature. Tenderness is present over the anterior hip joint line. Bilateral femoral pulses are equally palpable. There is no tenderness, irregularity or thickening of the vapor trochanter. There is no swelling palpable in the scapular triangle and in the gluteal region. On examination of the movements, the right hip has a flexion deformity of 25 degrees, which was confirmed by the Thomas's test, and further flexion up to 125 degrees. As compared to the left, there is a flexion of 125 degrees in the left hip with extension of 0 to 20 degrees. Right hip has an adduction deformity of 20 degrees with further adduction up to 10 degrees. On the left, there is abduction up to 50 degrees and adduction of 30 degrees. The right hip has an external rotation deformity of 15 degrees with further rotation up to 20 degrees, whereas the external rotation is 40 degrees in the left hip with an internal rotation of 30 degrees. For measurements, there is a wasting of 2.5 cm of the thigh muscles measured at a point which lies 10 cm proximal to the medial joint line of the knee. There is an apparent shortening of 1.5 cm of the right limb and on true shortening of 3 cm which was obtained after squaring the pelvis. Segmental shortening was obtained in the femur of about 3 cm and a Bryan's triangle indicated that there is a shortening of a base, that it is a supratrochanteric shortening. This was confirmed by the Nelaton's line, on which the tip of the GT lied above the line on examination. The Schumacher's lines crossed below the umbilicus on the left side, and the Cheney's lines were not parallel but were convergent on the right side. The patient was unable to perform an active SLR. He had a telescopic test positive on the right, and a Trendelenburg's test was also positive. The desired sign obtained on rotation of the lateral trochanter was also positive. He had no neurovascular deficit. On examination of the spine, there was a compensatory scoliosis with curve to the left side. The ipsilateral knee had no abnormalities. The ipsilateral ankle had a 15 degree compensatory equinus. And the opposite left hip, knee and ankle had no abnormalities. To summarize, my patient, a 65-year-old male, complains of pain in the right hip with difficulty in weight bearing and walking, affecting his activities of daily living since 6 months. He sustained trauma to the hip, which was treated with traction. He has a Trendelenburg's gait with tenderness over the anterior hip joint line and a fixed deformities of flexion of 25 degrees, external rotation of 15 degrees and adduction of 20 degrees with a true supratrochanteric shortening of 3 cm. He has an active SLR absent with positive Trendelenburg's and telescopic tests. My provisional diagnosis is right non-union neck femur fracture of about 6 months duration, which was treated conservatively. I'd like to give a differential of delayed or malunited intertrochanteric hip and old tuberculosis hip with bony changes, which I can rule out only after further investigation.